the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and withered. And they gather them and throw them into the fire, and they are burned. If you abide in me, my words abide in you. We like this part. Love this part. But before we got here, there were some other things that had to be done. There was so much that had to have been accomplished in order for us to get here. You had to have been fruitful. You had to have remained. You had to have gone through some cutting, chipping, pruning, so that you can get to this point. But we all want to skip over 1 to 6 and read 7, and you quote it all your life and you get nowhere because you refuse to do what the first part of the scripture says. But you want to quote this when you're in trouble. Let me see. When you're in trouble, when crisis shows up in your family, when crisis shows up in your life, when crisis shows up in your mind, you can put the lights brighter so you can see the faces. Amen? We want to quote, if you abide in me and my word abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done.
Amen.
We love those scriptures. We love the prosperity scriptures. But there is a word that has to be done ahead before you can begin to claim. You got to put in the word. We all love to quote, my God shall supply all my needs according to your riches in glory. He was speaking to a church that supported him, that sent money to him when he was in need. So he said, hence, my God will supply all your needs.
Amen.
Don't try to steal what doesn't belong to you this morning. You got to put in the work. You've got to abide. You've got to remain to this sermon. It's called Servants Abide. As servants of God, we are called to live in Christ. In Him we live. In Him we move. When you live somewhere, that's your residence. You're not visiting. If you're living in Christ, you're consistently obeying Him every step of the way. You're not visiting Him morning for 5 minutes and, oh God, thank you for today. Let me go to work, make a lot of money, and come back home, save that car, don't knock me down. When I come home with my money, car can knock me down before I reach, but when I get my money, don't knock me down. No! If you're abiding means you're remaining, you're taking up residence. When I left Guyana in 2000, I came to America, I became a resident of America. I'm not a resident of Guyana. As much as we love our homeland, we're not residents of that land anymore.
Amen.
When you collect that green card, you've been rejected by your homeland.
Amen.
Yeah. When you go there and then furthermore, you become a citizen. And sometimes some of you go back home and you want to join the residents line.
Yes.
And then they say, no, you don't belong here. You need to go to the other side. You got a blue passport. Yeah, but if we're abiding, we're remaining, we're taking up residence, we're permanent, we're not shifting. Abiding doesn't speak of one day in, one day out, one day up, one day down. No! The Bible says many are the afflictions of a righteous. There's afflictions in abiding. Abiding is not easy. There's temptation in abiding. Listen, not because you're tempted means you're not abiding. Let's go to the word. Luke 17:1. It says, then he said to the disciples, who said?
Jesus
said to them, it is impossible that no offenses shall come. But woe to him through whom the offense comes. The word offense there is the Greek word scandalos. That sounds very scandalous, doesn't it? It represents temptation. It's not someone offending you. Right? It speaks of temptation as a bait or a trap or a scheme of the devil. When a temptation comes, what are you going to do? Exit from God? Run away from God? Or are you going to run to God? You're going to abide more. You're going to throw yourself at the mercy seat. You're going to, because temptation is not sin. Can I go there? Let me take time. Temptation is not sin. How do we know temptation is not sin? Joseph, the life of Joseph. Let's look at two lives. Let's look at the life of Samson and the life of Joseph. Both of them were presented with situations. Amen. Both of them were called by God. Yes. Both of them